got to get better.
Greetings. Today we're here with Brother Babanu, the author of two heavyweight books, The God Genes Decoded 1 and 2. Brother Babanu, how are you?
I'm doing good today, man. You know, it's really good to meet you. You know, you're over from England, you're visiting New York City. You know, how do you like it so far, man?
It's quite interesting meeting with different spiritual masters, priests, some people I know from before, and some people are new on the scene, like yourself, and it's quite an interesting one.
Okay.
Yeah. Babanu, your name on the author, the name on the book is R.A. Walden. Is that your former name, or is that still a name that you use?
Well, that's the name that I was given at birth.
Okay.
You know, I was born on the island of Barbados, and you know, there wasn't really much culture in terms of indigenous culture down there. You know, whether it was from the African slaves or captives that were brought there, or it was from the Caribs that were there when they arrived. When I grew up on the island, I really didn't see any remnants of it. You know, I didn't even see it in Christianity. Like, there wasn't any form of indigenous culture seen in none of the Christian institutions. And you know, in our perspective, it was a Christian country. We had to say prayers every single morning, and we used the Bible. We had to memorize passages of the Bible, Psalms. You know, I can recall being in school and having about 25 minutes to memorize a psalm because I didn't do my homework. Mm-hmm. And other people in the class are like trembling, because if you don't memorize a psalm and say it in front of every single body, word for word, you're going to get spanked. Mm-hmm. Really, really hard, you know. That teacher's name was Miss Waterman. And, you know, she really enjoyed using that bamboo. It would sting really, really hard. So, man, I remember that psalm. It was Psalm 100.
Okay.
And I remember that psalm. The guy next to me didn't. He was crying and I was singing.
Okay.
You know?
I'm from the island as well, and we have similar culture in terms of different oppressive system in the Caribbean. We have the Christianity. I'm from Montserrat in Caribbean. But the focus is on your book. Tell us a little about the cover before we start opening and looking inside about the God Gene Decoded. Tell us on the cover for book one.
Well, you know, that's Amun, Mut, and Khonsu. This is Amun, that's Mut, this is Khonsu, and that's a pharaoh giving honors and praise to Amun. Now, when I began writing this book, I was looking to decode the universe, some voice or some idea I had was that I needed to do this for several reasons that all encompass the discipline of healing. You know, the type of roles that the shamans, the priests or priestesses played in indigenous civilizations, and something pointed me to chemistry and biology to figure it out. And I would say many years later I realized that we live in a very, very advanced biological system. You know, some people call it the universe, you know. So, knowing that Amun is diatomic oxygen and the ozone layer, and that, you know, Khonsu is the moon, and then knowing that somehow something happened where the moon was birthed from the ozone layer of the planet, is what this cover alludes to, you know, and the fact that the ozone layer is blue because the ozone layer is water. So, you know, some voice had told me that the third planet from the sun was created with water. It was an ancestral voice. And later I realized that water is the basis of life. That's why my name is Nu.
See?
Because I needed to know that the wisdom you're looking for is in water.
Okay. Stop there for a minute. When I heard the name Baba Nu, I thought, okay, this is a priest that knows. So I'm looking at Nu as knowledge as well. Right. But I understand Nu is also the hidden, is how it's mentioned.
Nu are the primordial waters. They speak of the primordial waters of Nu as the origins of the universe, meaning that they're saying that the universe is birthed out of water.
Yes.
And I realize it's birthed out and within water, it stays in water. So the planet is staying in water for a reason. The planet is surrounded by...
Is that similar to the ambient fluid?
We're still in the sack.
Okay.
We are still in the sack of Newt.
See.
So we're still children.
Listen, ain't no sense in voting. Same song with a different name. But it sure feels just the same. Ain't nothing fair about welfare. Ain't no assistance in aid. Ain't nothing affirmative about your actions till the people get paid. Your 1,000 years are up. Now you got to share the land. Section 1, the 14th Amendment says no state shall deprive any person of life, liberty, or property without due process of law. Mr. May, we want to end this letter with 3 words. We tired of y'all.